something on your lip.
Yeah, you want to lick it off, babe?
Take more than that to make me happy.
Oh, shit!
Oh! of the night, huh? I'll take whatever you have on tap. Really went out here. Get a lot of tourists or something? Hey, buddy, how about that beer? Hey, pal, how about that beer? Pal. Hey. What is with your friend here? What is he, fucking deaf? Hey, you. Hey, man, my money spends here just as well as anybody else. Jesus!
Get wet. Quit your bitching.
Don't.
This? says you're wrong.
Oh, you're on. Hey, Coach.
Yes, Gwen.
So, since you're going to be so busy, don't you think it's best if I drove?
Uh-huh, and how am I going to be busy?
Well, you haven't made the reservations for the hotel yet, right?
No, I already did that.
So then why don't you have a confirmation number yet?
There better be a mini bar at the motel.
And how did you know that?
I never ask a question I don't know the answer to, Coach.
Very good.
There's more to this world than just logic.
Observe, analyze, and counter.
You're so cold and calculating.
Just hand it over, loser.
You're good. Mandy!
What?
You're only supposed to pack the bare essentials.
And I did. It's got my evening formal, my couture casuals. Oh, these cute little red pumps. A micro mini, my Dolce capris, and my brand new Prada bag.
Pack party clothes. For a tournament in Arizona.
On the contrary. I'm just making sure that I look the part for when we win. Now, if you tell me that we're going to lose, I'll just leave all of this behind.
Point goes to Mandy. Hey, Jerry, at least you didn't better your last dollar.
Okay, okay.
Is everybody ready? All right, where are we going?
Phoenix!
What are we going to do?
To debate with a clear mind, clear arguments, and a clear goal in sight.
And what is that goal?
To kick ass, sir!
That's right. Everybody in.
Or maybe you're just jealous of my brand new high school.
Get that out of my face! Hey, Buck, you can get us all killed.
Why enough, Gwen?
No, not when I'm driving.
Yeah, like there's anything out here but prairie dogs and road runners. That...
Look out! What was that?
Oh my god.
Oh god, oh god, oh god.
What just happened?
No.
All right, everyone stay right here.
Coach. Sorry.
Don't move. We're gonna call the paramedics and you're gonna be fine. Where does it hurt?
Right here.
Up. Up. Turn around. Turn around. Slow. Slow.
What's up?
It beats me. Can't see a thing. Looks like the guy's walking. Can't be too bad.
Hey, Coach, is that guy okay?
Oh, God.
Hey, miss, get us out of here.
Where are we going?
Go straight and under the speedway for now. I'll let you know when we get there.
How is it we didn't kill you?
Little carjack trick. Slap the side of the car loud enough to give everyone inside panic. Pull over. Pull over.
Take
come
me.
On.
Take
sit
me.
Down.
No, I'll go.
I recall of telling you to sit down, and I won't say it a third time. Come on.
It's okay, Coach. I'll go.
Daryl! Damn, Daryl! Damn! Fuck!
What's the matter?
What's the matter is my ex-business partner just fucked me out of 50 grand in cash and blow. Fuck! Let's get, come on. Come on. Open the trunk.
I'm okay.
Take this road right here.
This one?
What did I just say?
But it's a dirt road, a track. It probably doesn't even lead.
It leads directly where I want it to. Move it.
Sunset Valley.
Jerry, you've actually heard of this place?
Yeah, but I never believed it existed.
There's nobody here.
It looks like a ghost town.
If this is the place I've heard of, it has more than just ghosts.
Let the kids go. Do whatever you need to do, but leave the kids. I'll take you where you need to go.
Oh, just like that, huh? You must think I'm stupid, too.
No, I don't think you're stupid. It's just that fewer hostages means fewer people to keep an eye on, fewer people to worry about. Come on, just let the kids go.
Nice try. Don't try it again. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on, let's go! Come on, get out. Come on.
Come on, man, move it.
Come on, come on! Come on! Wait right here, whoa, not so fast. You got something I want. Come on. Everybody inside, come on!
Missing. Shit.
somebody's taking a sword.
Guys, there's something not right here.
Hey, anyone else's watch stop?
Yeah, mine.
Mine too.
Hello? Hey, anybody in here? Hello?
Bloody Bill.
And I will, just as soon as I take you care of your business.
I don't understand. They'll find you.
Where's the cash, Daryl? Where's the cash?
So hungry. He's coming. He'll find you.
Who's gonna do what?
Please, Earl. He'll kill you.
Help!
Oh,
hit him!
Hit
me!
Ah!
There's a first aid kit in the back. Okay, you're being fine.
Where is he?
Thank you.
Anybody here?
Was that?
Shit.
Ah.
Jerry, sweetie, focus on something else, okay?
Burns like a motherfucker.
Shit.
That's fucked. Careful.
Okay, Jerry, just let's have a look at that.
God damn. Oh,
man, it looks infectious.
Think whatever bit me bit Sandy's.
It just doesn't make any sense. How could he just up and disappear like that?
I don't know. I'm sorry. It's okay. I don't know.
He must have been on drugs or something. PCP, mescaline.
Does PCP make you bulletproof?
No, but it's the only logical explanation.
Hey, Dara wasn't a user. Just fucking greedy. Must have hit that bastard 3 to 4 times in the heart at least.
Didn't he say something about a bloody bill?
Yeah, he did. Could be. Legend has it that he fled from the Union Army out to these parts. It's not inconceivable that Bloody Bill came out here and, I don't know, did something to this place.
Jerry, you're talking about Bloody Bill as if he's still alive.
Is it really that far-fetched? The Bible's full of tales and references of people returning from the dead. Why not him?
Jerry, the Bible's an unsubstantiated source of information. It's an invalid argument.
So you're saying the beliefs of the world's 3 major religions are invalid?
No, I'm saying it's unsubstantiated. There's a big difference.
If he somehow staked a claim on this town, we're all in a lot of trouble. The man was pure evil. It's as simple as that. No. He was so mean that no one could kill him.
One story has it that the lynch mob got their hands on Bloody Bill while he was sleeping. But Bloody Bill took a long time to die, only succumbing to the crowd when they struck him down with his own saber, the only weapon it seemed that could kill him. Everyone had lived in mortal terror of the man for so long that when he was finally at their mercy, they paid him back for every crime he had ever committed. But the townsfolk were frightened of his alliance with the devil, and feared that killing him with his own sword was not enough. So after they stabbed him, they burned the coffin where he lay just to make sure he wouldn't escape or somehow free himself. Bloody Bill Anderson died in agony and darkness and flame, cursing the town that judged him so cruelly as the flames consumed his casket, swearing that if he had to claw his way back from hell itself, he would make them all pay.
Lynch mob shot and stabbed him dozens of times, and even then it was only a lucky hit from his own sword that killed him.
No shit.
It gets worse. The only thing he hated more than Yankees was black people.
What was that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
Huh? I hear that tone in your voice. You got a problem with
no,
me?
No, I don't know.
Huh? You got a problem?
No.
Fuck away, huh? You got a problem with me?
No.
The
wait,
fuck
wait,
you
wait,
don't?
No,
wait.
No,
you
no,
don't?
No,
wait,
no,
wait.
No. He's talking about Bloody Bill, a Confederate raider, right?
Yes.
So then he doesn't like any of us. Just drop it, okay?
Better watch that tone with me, you understand? Watch that tone.
Oh, God.
Sandra.
No, don't!
Why is it still sunset?
What?
Quiet.
Look, I should have told you, but she didn't just abandon us.
Yeah, I know. That's what has me so worried.
And there she is!
He's gonna come out the rest
calm
next, right?
Calm down, Buck!
Fuck, calm! I am waiting around just for some fucking lunatic to mistake me for one of you! I'm from Georgia! Fuck this,
hey,
I'm out of here!
Calm down!
Buck, come back! Don't go!
Hey, come back! Hey! Hey, last warning!
Try me. Try me. Back up, back up, back up, back up!
Gwen, he's got a gun!
Oh.
fuck, man? That's gonna make you feel better. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Don't think for a second. I forgot who brought us here. She must still be alive. Here's your bag. Guess I gotta trust you now.
What the fuck? I've been here before. Sandra? Sandra, is that you? Where are you?
Sandra? Jesus, what's your life?
We need to get him to a doctor, bad.
I don't think we're gonna find any of those around here.
Damn. Well, then back to the hotel.
No, I'm fine.
Jerry, what's really? The matter?
Oh, God.
What's going on?
My stomach, creeping up real bad.
Gwen, we're gone, Jerry. We're on your feet. It just needs a new bandage is all. Okay, Jay, hold on. This may sting a minute, okay?
God.
gonna be okay. Jerry, what's the matter? What's wrong?
Damn it, my stomach.
What? What is it?
Killing me.
Quinn, we have to do something.
My stomach.
What? What is it?
Let me try and find you something to eat. Jerry, you have to tell me. Is it like poisoning?
It's like I'm starving.
Starving?
Is that you?
My dearest sister, though you are no more, know that through me you will have your vengeance. And if the god to whom you implored me to supplicate myself saw fit to leave you defenseless, then perhaps Satan will see fit to grant me the strength of arm needed to see my duty fulfilled. The town of Sunset Valley has sealed its fate, and I will see them damned, if not in this life, then with my next.
She was Bill's sister.
Mary had moved out west sometime near the end of the war, hoping to begin life anew. And while she herself had no part in her brother's evil deeds, he cast a long shadow, one she could not escape from. When the locals discovered Mary's brother was none other than the infamous Bloody Bill Anderson, they hanged her. Whether out of fear or hatred for vengeance, vigilantes took her out and executed her. Unfortunately for them, the troubles didn't end with Mary's life. Bloody Bill had tracked his sister down, hoping for a life of peaceful anonymity after the war, but all he found was her stiffening corpse swaying in the wind. It was then that he swore to make the entire town pay for what they had done.
Oh, oh my God. Mandy, get Jerry and go hide. Give me the keys.
Gwen, lower the gun.
It's okay, I've got it under control. Give me the keys, we'll find Buck, and we'll leave you here with whoever killed Sandra. Give me the fucking keys!
Listen, we just spent the last 10 minutes here trying not to get eaten alive. If all the same for you, I suggest you point that thing somewhere else.
What the hell is going on here?
I don't know, all right? Not everything has an explanation. I know what I saw, I know what I smelled. And trust me, once you smell death, you never mistake it for anything else.
Dead? What do you mean they're dead? They're not dead, it's something else. Toxins, fallout, mutations.
I know. And this doesn't make a lot of sense, but sometimes you just have to trust that what you see is what you're getting. If we want to make it out of here, we're going to have to work together. Okay, Spore? Good. Okay. Everybody out in the van. We're getting out of here.
Right now?
You want to stay here, do you?
No, but what about Buck?
What about Buck?
We can't just leave him here.
I didn't say we were leaving him. I just... Jerry needs a doctor, and we just can't go looking for Buck on foot.
Well, we can at least stay here for a minute before we abandon him.
Look, Jerry needs a hospital. We don't have time to sit around here waiting for him to come back.
I say fuck him. He ran off like a little pussy and left you guys here to dangle. Shit, he's probably dead already.
We do not know that yet.
Honey, there's possible and probable. Right now, your friend falls into neither.
We are not gonna leave him here to die.
It's okay for us to leave Jerry here to die?
All right, that's enough.
Yeah, you're damn right it's enough. He gets us in this fucking mess and then he expects us to leave our friend here to die?
Oh, so it's all my fault now.
End of discussion! Mandy and Gwen, you get Jerry out to the van. We're gonna drive around and look for Buck. At the first sign of trouble, we are getting out of here.
But...
this is not up for debate! We either find him or we don't. I am not endangering lives for him. Do I make myself clear?
He got them all. All of them! And he's gonna get us. He's gonna get us too. Don't Jerry me! We're all damned. All of us. Don't any of you see? Bloody Bill came here, and he never left. No one leaves.
Jerry, listen to me.
Cursed! Cursed them all. Cursed us. With his dying breath, he cursed us.
Jerry! Listen. I know the evidence seems to support the legend, but there is a reasonable and logical explanation for all of this. Dead people do not just get up and start eating people.
Well, what about Coach Dent? He saw them.
They could be sick, psychotic, any number of reasons. Ergo, Erlman's disease.
You're wrong. This place is cursed. And so am I. So am I.
This says you're wrong.
Okay. You're on.
Right shotgun, if it isn't Buck, put it down.
Right off towards the edge of town.
Great, that's where we'll start. Let's hope we find it before anything else does.
Yeah.
point that thing, you hear?
Don't worry about me. Terry, how you holding up over here? What was that?
Thank God it stopped.
What are we gonna do?
No one leaves.
No one gets out.
That's enough crazy talk out of you, boy.
Leave him alone.
He's back to claim us all.
Somebody better say the fucking lie or I'll shoot this guy.
He's back to claim us all. Just like he claimed the others.
Tell your boyfriend to be quiet, okay?
You know what? Both of you, stop arguing. We're getting out of here right now. Earl, grab an arm. Screw you!
Jesus Christ, what's that smell?
Jerry, come on, we gotta get you out of here. Get up, Jerry. Come on, Jerry. We can all make it. We're not gonna leave anyone else behind.
I got no say in the matter. I'm staying here whether I like it or not.
But we don't even know.
Don't even try. What happened to your friend, to all these people, is gonna happen to me. You know it. I know it. And we all know that's no way for anyone to go. Even for someone like me. Besides, I have a few things to say to that racist bitch before I check out.
Earl?
Now get the hell out of here! Don't look back! A pusher, a user, a thief, a
I'm breathing, sure. But that's just a technicality. It's time to do some good. 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 It's time to do. Who the fuck am I kidding? I'm not gonna be that good. Fuck this shit. Oh, yeah.
Oh my goodness, we made it. They're all gone. We made it. We're gonna be okay.
I know, but we have to get going, okay?
But no, we're gonna be okay. We're still here, right?
Hey.
Oh my God.
Mandy, you run when I tell you to, okay?
No, it can't be.
Wait for
Earl?
Mandy?
Earl! Is that you? Thank God! Thank God it's you!
Let's just say some obliging fellas got in the way of those explosives for me.
Obliging? What's up with the accent?
Thank you.
sweet time, I run outside. I find somebody that's ready to fight. Everybody that's crossed my way has found no rest and ran away. All the time I stay alone. I wish I was them crushing some bones. Blood, blood, more to feel. I need to satisfy all my needs. Blood, blood, more to feel. I need to satisfy all my needs. My self-invasion lives out
in
frustration. My self-invasion lives out in frustration. Stay inside, I fear the night. Followed by the darkness, much too bright. Every time I run outside, I find somebody that's ready to fight. Everybody that's crossed my way has found no rest and ran away. All the time I stay alone. I wish I was there crushing down bones. Blood, blood, more to feel. I need to satisfy all my needs.
No,
blood,
this can't be.
Blood,
this.
More to feel. I need to satisfy all my needs. My self-invasion lives out in frustration. My self-invasion lives out in frustration. My self-invasion lives out in frustration.
Lay down. He returns to us.